Hello viewers, welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video I'm going to do the Let's Play Train Simulator. And in this game, I'm going to drive a Pacer train, Class 143, built by some manufacturer and Alexander. So let's put classic Pacer. Alexander built only two trains, 143 and another one. The other one is also Pacer, by the way. Now, so this train has got an accompanying something engine at, I think, 200 something horsepower. And hydraulic gearbox by Voith, I think. Acceleration has got, there are 7 steps of acceleration and 3 steps of brake plus emergency, so 3 steps of service brake, 7 steps of acceleration and acceleration and brake. Throttle and brake are separate. Throttle is on the right and brake is on the left. Well, that's how it is in real life. But in the game, you use A and D. You use A to increase throttle and D to decrease throttle. But you use semicolon to... You use semicolon to decrease brake and... quotation mark to increase brake. That is a bit annoying because it's switched in on the keyboard layout. Now I forgot to make my tea for this, so I do apologize for myself. I usually drink tea. Am I being a bit late? And the route I'm driving, this is his first hook, it goes to Dawlish. Am I pronouncing it right? I hope so. So it comes with the path. And of course I also have the South Wales coastal road. That's from another path. Class 143 is a Pacer, and a Pacer is a rare bus. Basically, when they had the idea to build Pacer trains, it was around World War II, I think, I'm not quite sure, and they wanted to cut cost, so they made... They took the bodies for buses and did the conversion to them. Put them on freight chassis, freight wrapping chassis, and boom, there you go, Pacer trains. Well, that's what actually one of the reasons why I like them, because I like buses. Like buses, each car with Paisley train has got two axles. They don't have bogies, they're set with axles. The axles are kind of built into the body, built into the chassis. They're not set on a bogie. Each car has got two axles. To be honest, I think it's a bit noisy. It starts, it doesn't really struggle too much to pick up speed, but as it goes fast, it starts to struggle to pick up speed. Yeah. Oh yeah, of course I like Pacers, by the way. Still look good. They're amazing. Thinking of a brilliant, it's a rare bus, and it was built by Alexander. Not all Pacers were built by Alexander, but this particular one was. And Alexander was a bus manufacturer. They mainly built buses and trains. They used to build some trains. And of course it's merged now with Dennis and Bus. Formed Alexander Dennis. I'm thinking, what if I have a bus that also goes out to rail? Well, I think that actually can fit a bit, because in the UK, the train driver's seat is on the left-hand side and the bus driver's seat is on the right-hand side. And we have like the entire point. I sit on the left to drive in railway mode, I sit on the right to drive in bus mode. That sounds kind of funny, but I guess it would be terrible if it's actually bad. I'm not quite sure about the top speed of this thing. It kind of struggles to top speed, so even if it has got a top speed, I will not reach the top speed because the acceleration is so cool at the top speed. Is it something to do with the bloody hydraulic gearbox? To be honest, I quite like hydraulic gearbox. Well, a hydraulic gearbox is basically a torque converter. I don't think they're different, but it would be terrible if buses don't have a torque converter. Well, on the bus, a bus depends on the gearbox, the actual gears. Those are known as gear steps. Or like that bit is. Well, trains also have that. Some trains. It will be called mechanical gearbox on the train. And just a gearbox on the bus. And the other thing, it would be called a hydraulic gearbox or hydraulic transmission on the train, and a torque converter on the bus. But I think that is a big something. And a bus is more dependent on the gearbox instead of the torque converter. A train is more dependent on the torque converter. It's like it goes to you. I actually quite like the function of the torque converter, because suppose it functions a bit better, because well, in ETS2 I don't think the token board is spotted in there, even if you have the Allison Ultimate gearbox. Well, I found it a bit weird to have an Ultimate gearbox without a token board. Quite like this view, but the graphics are a bit terrible. It just feels so strange to drive a truck without drinking tea. Well, most of you probably know that I love tea. By the way, the door is a bit funny. So basically, you've got for the front car, it's got two doors. It's got one door on the left hand side and two doors on the right hand side. It's the same for this one. If that's the front, that's the left hand side. So basically, I'm not quite sure if these are converted from buses. And also, let me show you a bit the that's it. It's a bit annoying, there's no There's no speed limit warning sign. Maybe there is, I just missed it, but if you're to be a real train driver, you need to remember the speed limits. It's part of the route knowledge that you require to. So even though there's no speed limit warning sign, you need to know the speed limit. I just don't. Because I'm not a good train driver. Step entrance. Yeah. It's not even low floor. It is step entrance. That can be a bit annoying. I mean, well, the bus is probably step entrance. Brilliant. Okay, I'm approaching my last stop, which is Dawlish. It doesn't really matter because it's still it's really weird. I think, well, the HSTs are being replaced by the bloody Hitachi Rail Class. No, Hitachi Class 800. Good thing is that they're diesel trains still. The diesel, electric diesel trains. So it's basically a dual mode. And the bad thing is that they're far, way far behind to capture with HST. Well, HST is an absolute beast. And there's just nothing that can replace it. And it's the world's fastest diesel train. I do agree that HSTs look a bit weird, but I quite like them. It feels quite nice to drive one in terms of data. And also, it's modded to the new game called Transit World. I actually kind of want to try Transit World, but it's quite annoying because you have to get the base game. CSX Haulage, that's in Eastern America, I believe, which is the bit I don't like, and I have absolutely no interest in that. But I am interested in, so basically, TSW, Transit World, has got a DLC, which is Great Western Express. It's got a Class 66. Feels by electro diesel, that's a locomotive. And class 43 HST. plus one six six turbo networked turbo. I quite fancy those three trains on that route, but it's a DLC, and if you want it, you have to get base game. You have to get a CSX heavy voltage, which is different. I care nothing about. Might be late, hopefully not. Anyway, I'm turning off the engine. Brilliant. And yep, I approached my last stop. Hello. Thank you very much for watching, and see you next time. Hang on. Well done, driver. There seems to be a lot of talking between the commuters. Let's hope it is still positive regarding the look and feel of the refurbishment. You provided a nice run for them, thank you. I got 1,000 points, which is the highest one you can get for each scenario. Anyway, thank you very much for watching, and good night.